Be a scientist is what Mataji urges you to do. She's here now, so she's going to give you the experience tonight after the talk. Be receptive to her. And when the experience comes, start to look at the whole process. Start to look at the whole process almost as if it were a big drama happening in front of you. Again, ladies and gentlemen, Mataji Nemala Devi.
Somebody's banking.
Because we can't control the volume, you'll have to.
Is it?
We can't control it. It's okay, but you need to speak fairly close. Mm.
But I could hear you outside in that doorway.
Good. Then I'll just take it over this way.
It's a funny one, I must say.
I think we'll take it back this way, Mother.
It's like...
the snake.
It's like the seekers. Yesterday, I told you about a general idea about the chakras, and about the powers that we have within us. But my main concern yesterday was to instill in you the sincerity with which you must seek. That you have to be honest to yourself to get to the truth. This is the only payment you have to make for Sahaja Yoga. That you have to be really honest to yourself. I'm not here to gain anything from you. That's one point, should be absolutely clear. You cannot give me anything, I cannot take anything from you. Now, when we come to that point, the second point is we have to be honest about it. Many people believe that whatever way you go to God is not true. Also, some people believe that if you do wrongs and harm to others, still you will go to God. It's true, no doubt, you can, but not because you have done anything wrong. You will go to God because you have decided to be good people, to be people who are seeking God in the true sense of the word. So when you are seeking the truth, you must first of all ask a question within yourself, are we really seeking the truth? So many fixations that we have within us have to be dropped. And gradually you will see for yourself, as you grow in your self-realization, that these fixations drop automatically. Like a flower becomes a fruit, then the calyx of the flower drops out. So many parts of the flower drop out. As I told you, there has to be transformation and transmutation. So the part of the transformation does take place, but the transmutation, you have to work it out. Now, for that, as I told you yesterday, that the transformation is a true living. Again, I say living. I don't know if people understand the meaning of the word living. Living happening in us, taking place out of the living force again within us, and is manifested by the living God within us. Perhaps we have never been able to judge the working of the living, which is so spontaneous. It's a mystery for us. It's a mystery. We just take it for granted. Whatever is mysterious, the human nature is such, take it for granted. So, as I told you, that within you, this Kundalini, the desire to become one with the Divine, is placed in the triangular bone called as sacra. Within you it is placed, it is there. You don't have to go anywhere to find it, it is there. In all of you it is placed there. Now, if it is placed there, then one must know that it has to be something very special for a special work. Otherwise, what is the need for God to place an energy down there? Well, the right person, in the sense, like the Mother Earth, as I told, who has the power to germinate a seed? Mother Earth has the power to do some living work. We do not have, we cannot germinate a seed. So, if such a person who has that warmth, that love of the Mother Earth, again, love doesn't mean sex. Sex has nothing to do. Sex is nonsense. Do not confuse it with God. Those who confuse with it are people from hell. They are from hell. And they take you down to it. Whether you like it or not, I have to tell you the truth. So, this holy energy, this auspicious thing, this sublime desire within us to be one with the Divine resides within us. This power resides within us. Now, do not cheat yourself on this point. Sex you can do. I mean, the animals do it, everybody do it, even the people, of every primitive stage can do it. You don't need any knowledge for that. It is just there. It's a reproduction. Whatever you can do is not divine. This is the point I try to make. Now, if you are making money out of it and this thing, then I have nothing to say. I mean, if you want to sell God, you can sell it. But you will be put in the hell. You take it from me for that kind of a nonsense. You cannot make money out of God. You cannot put sex on the Kundalini. It's like having sex with your mother. With your mother, the Holy Mother. It's absurd, it's wrong. I don't know how people can think like that. And they accept the situation. An Indian understands this better. I don't know, these days Indians also, I mean, we have gurus who are preaching this in India, horrible people. So one has to first of all understand that this energy which is within us has nothing to do with sex. I am not here to contest any lectures or any favoritism for them. Even if there is one person, I'll tell the truth. If there are hundreds, I'll tell the truth. There are 500, even if you stone me, I'll tell the truth. And I have to tell you the truth. I'm not here for any gain whatsoever, and I'm not afraid of anyone. Because I know what I have to do with you. You are seekers. You are seekers of ages. William Blake has mentioned about you in his book, Milton. He says, in those days, the men of God means seekers. You are seekers. First of all, accept this position within you that you are seekers. You are not here for a fashion. Accept this situation. There is no place in Sahaja Yoga for a person who is not a seeker. We do not want people here who are not true seekers. So first of all, you are a seeker. You are men of God. You are seeking God within yourself. If you are seeking God within yourself, he has said that they will become prophets and they will have a special capacity to make others prophets. This is a prophesy. Only about 100 years back is prophesied. So when you go to some guru, if you are honest, if you are a businessman, I have nothing to say. You better go ahead with your business in the name of God. I mean, we have many like this. But if you are honest and if you want to do good to yourself and to others, then you must judge it on this point that if you become the prophet in the modern times, then prophets have capacity to make others prophets. That means you must have the capacity to become the spirit, not only that, but also to make others. This is indicated already. I don't know how many people read him, but he is one of the greatest poets of the modern times. Of course, we have people like Kabira, Nanaka, they all have said. Kabira was such a tremendous man that he ousted all these horrible people, these Kriya Yogis and all that, and the Kecharis and everything, right and left. But even if you have not read him and understood him, you have got Milton, the book written by such a great poet like William Blake. Of course, Wordsworth and all these people are realized souls. But I would say that William Blake was a man with that kind of a tremendous power to explain what should happen to you. And that's what exactly should happen to you, that you become a prophet and you should be able to make others prophets. Not prophets. Prophet. Now, this power is kept there already. You are made like that. God has made you so beautifully, just see. With the colors and everything within. He has given you such a beautiful inner being. While we out in our freedom have gone wrong. We've forgotten God. We are not afraid of Him. We are not afraid of Him. We do not know that what He can do to us. In our freedom we have become so ego-oriented that our freedom has misled us. Doesn't matter. As long as you are seekers and truthful, it will work out. Now the first center, yesterday I told you about the left side power and the right side power. The left side power, as I said, is the power of your desire by Ichha Shakti, by which, or Mana Shakti, it's called as Mana. Now those people who are teaching you yoga are teaching you how to control your Prana Shakti, the right side. But what about the Mana Shakti? Such people can become very, very dry-hearted, absolutely dry. They could be so hot-tempered. We had many people like that in Vishwamitra and all these people. We had Durvasa. Very hot-tempered people. There's no love. There's no balance in them. And such people can only sort of mesmerize other people or can just kill other people and do all kinds of such acts of violence that you cannot explain. Any spiritual man doing all this violence all the time. And if you see the fanatics, all the fundamentalists are like that. All the fundamentalists are dry people. They are driven to the right side. They think they are the right people. All the rest are wrong. And the example of that is already Mr. Khomeini before you. And so many like that, Catholicism, Presbyterians, all these, Seventh-day Adventists in Christianity. In Hinduism also we have lots of such people. There's one Shankaracharya who is trying to make nowadays in India a big umbrella of gold studded with diamonds. I think he's trying to compete with your Pope. And that umbrella will fall on his head one day. It is going to be so heavy. All these things, you see, show that these people have nothing to do with God. Christ has said, you'll be amazed, Christ has said that these are the hypocrites, the Pharisees. These are the people who are standing at the gate of God that others should not enter inside because they cannot enter themselves. Very clearly he said, he has said it, you will be calling me Christ, Christ, I won't recognize you. These are the people. The so-called fundamentalists. It's not only the Islamic, it's not only the Hindus, it's not only the Buddhists. It's also the people who claim themselves to be very great protectors of religion. As Warren has told you just now, that you have to be a realized soul. Without realization, you have no right on God, you have no connection on God, you have nothing to say about God. You have no authority to describe. Minimum of minimum that you should be connected. It's like, say, I'm not connected to a president, I start talking about him, I'll be arrested. I have not known him, I have no connection, that nothing to do with him, I start taking his name, I'll be arrested. And that's why one has to know that to get to God, one has to become the spirit. Everyone has said that. I was today seeing one magazine and I was surprised at the shopping of God that is going on in this Los Angeles. I was really amazed. I said, where is my temple to be placed? All kinds of things. And the same words, your freedom, your liberation, even somebody had said that there's a tank in which you relax and you get your liberation. I mean, how can a tank give liberation? See, I don't have so many brains to understand this thing, I must say. I was amazed. How can people be fooled with such ideas that you get your liberation by getting into a tank or by jumping in the air, by taking out your clothes, by coloring your clothes or anything like that? Of course, Kabira has lashed it very much. And he has said about it. That's why I think Indians are wiser people. We have had great, great people in our country. It's really a great blessing to be born in that great country of ours, I must say. Though the greatest thugs are also born there, no doubt about it. The greatest thugs and the crooks are born there. But we have really such great people born in that country of ours that it's not easy for an Indian to accept nonsense without feeling guilty about it, without feeling bad about it. He cannot outright accept it. He may do it, but he is aware. So, as it is, this Kundalini is placed within us. Now, about Kundalini. Long time back, the search for Kundalini started, thousands of years back. The history is like this, that in the beginning, there were three types of people, we should say, who started searching in different areas. The first ones were the ones who started searching in the nature. What is the secret of the nature? Vedas are written on that. Vedas are the right side movement of people where they try to discover what are the deities, what are the different deities ruling the elements. You can see the great manifestation of that knowledge in Greece, even now, you can go and see in their history. And when I asked them, from where did you get these ideas, they told me that there was a Indo-Aryan report at a time, not at the time of Alexander, but much earlier when they came on this earth. Must have been, I'm sure, thousands of years back, the way the whole thing is described. And they came on this part of the earth, means Greece, and told us that there are these three powers and there are three deities, the three mothers who work it out. Imagine, at that time. And they have one goddess called as Athena. As I told you, Atha means the primordial. And she is the primordial Kundalini. She has a snake in her hand and she has all these chakras. Now this movement was on the right-hand side. Right-hand side was the Vedas, where they tried to discover the deities that are ruling the sun, the ruling the moon, the ruling the, the sea. The sea is ruled by Neptune, and it's called as Poseidon in this Greek way. And also they knew about Parshuram. Seers is Parshurama, who came before Rama, and he is one of the person who is an eternal being, who moves in every way. He is the one who is respected as Zeus, but people are quite confused because the Greeks brought all the gods to their land. The work of Vedas helped us to overcome the nature. You must have heard that at the time of Rama, they had aeroplanes. I've seen books written in India where they say that there were 685 gadgets in the aeroplane in those days. And they have ways and methods of having pilotless bombs and all that. Some people say that the Germans got these ideas only from Indian old ventures. But these they achieved by the right side movement, is to go to the essences of the elements and try to master them. But they knew, even the first verse of Vedas is that if by reading Veda, if you do not get the Veda, Veda is the knowledge. Veda comes from the word to know. Veda, if you do not become Vidvana, means if you do not get your realization, if you do not become the knowledge, it's useless. It's clearly written there. So the essence of Vedas is also that by knowing all these things, ultimately you should become realized. You should become the knowledge. Wherever Adi Shankaracharya has used the word the knowledge, it is meaning the knowledge of the all-pervading power, to become self-realized, knowledge of the self. Wherever Nanaka has used it, or wherever Ganeshwara has used it, it means the knowledge, means the knowledge of the self, Atmabodha. Atmabodha. If you read Shankaracharya, his book Atmabodha, very important. And you will know that he has described that when you get the knowledge, it's the self-knowledge, then only you will know about God. Clearly he said, I mean, so clear you can't crystal clear. He says that when Kabira said, padi padi pandita murakh bhaye, he said that by reading too much, even the wise have become stupid. I can see the result of that. Because when we read every nonsense, we have no discrimination power, we read every kind of a book, and it becomes like that. Now this, why did they do it? Why did the wise people try to find out the deities or the essences of all these elements? We should ask this question very clearly. And that is what is to be understood. That they understood that if you could go to the essence of these matter, that surrounds us, the elements, if you can somehow or other capture them, then at a time when you have reached a stage, a time when you have become ripe enough, as for modern times you can say, you will get more time to do your meditation. See, we are saving our time. You've got watches. We must save time, save time. For what? To waste in a pub? Every time we are saving our time, for what? To make some sort of a crooked stuff here and there? Where are we saving? It is just to save time. First important thing was, they wanted to save time. Because, you see, in the olden days, even to cook your food, it was so difficult. It's every instant these days. If you want to cook something, you just do it in 5 minutes, otherwise it used to take hours together. So, they thought that if you have the matter available to you, first point was to make you so efficient that you can save your time for meditation, for your ascent, for your realization. This was one of the reasons. Second, why? Because they know matter cannot give you happiness, matter cannot give you joy. Then why did they go into the secrets of the matter? Why did they try to find out the matter? What it is like? why science developed, why the knowledge of science came to human beings from the unconscious. We can ask the question, because what human beings have done is another point. They have made atom bombs. Even atom bomb is very useful, because seeing the atom bomb sitting there, people are sensitive. The nitrogen bomb has put heads together. All these hydrogen bombs, in a way, is good, because all these expansions are linear and they curl back. So even this movement was very good. But apart from that, the matter was developed in those days. It's a very great idea. One, and the simple thing was that when this collective happening takes place, where people will get a mass, in a very collective way, their realization, how should it happen in the whole world? What should be the method that should be used? After all, Christ came only, say, in that little part. After Christ, what is to be done? How to spread it to all the people? It was all thought out. So they created camera, TV, all those things. Now, on a TV, I can give realization, will be a minute. But they will never allow me to be there. You see, that's the trouble with the TV people. You have to pay them lots of money. On the TV, you can give. I have seen that in Hong Kong. On a TV, we could give realization to so many people. But they would not allow me. That's a different point. That may also work out later. We must have patience. But this was the reason to use all these things. Now, for instance, television has got everything in it. For example, it has got that collective manifestation. It has got all the art, color, everything in it. And you can work it out. And this collective happening can be spread out so fast into the whole world. At the time of Christ, this was not possible. Many people say that why didn't Christ do it? I mean, you cannot command him. It was in the proper growth of things that today you have reached that stage and it has to just click. That's why science developed to this thing. But it also had many other advantages. For example, these are byproducts of this advancement, I must say. For example, by developing, say, plastic, you got tired of it. By developing nylon, you got fed up of it. By having air fuels, you see, Indians in India are still developing. You are developed, overdeveloped. You are fed up of that development. You want to run back. I have heard that now there is a big movement to become like sticks because you are fed up of this advancement. So you are going backwards now. With the idea that now you are fed up of all this that you have done, these junks that you have created, these big mountains of plastics you have created, and you don't know what to do. So the affluence has its own advantage. By getting the affluence through your industrial revolution, you have reached a point that you say, oh God, had enough of it. Let's get out of this wasteland. It's the joke behind the whole thing. You just see, it has happened to you. And that has given you the greatest thing is the desire to find out something beyond. This frustration, this realization, this understanding of the fact that matter cannot give you joy has given you this special temperament. Of course, in India, you see, I saw some boys who were hippies. I asked them, why are you hippies? He said, now Americans are hippies, so we should be hippies also. But here the hippies are seeking beyond. You see, it's a thing they want to get rid of that nonsense, and that's why they are getting into it. It's not a thing they are just doing it because somebody else is doing it. But in India, people are doing it because Americans are doing it, so it's a fashion. There's no genuineness about it. But India, as I told you, is such a great country that even it just once decide that you want to have realization, you can get it. In India, it's very easy to work out because the country of yoga is especially, though the Indians may not be that good, especially the city people are enamored by the way you have plastics and the way, actually, you know, you'll be surprised when I go to India, I have to take some nylon sarees for the ladies there. Though we have silks, they like that. So the people who are developed are the people who are realizing and understanding that we have to have the blessing of the Divine. Otherwise, how to get? They are fed up. They are just fed up of their affluence, fed up of this thing, and they have sorted out everything. I mean, you tell anybody, oh, we know that. Now the end of it has come that they are also fed up of guru shopping. When they have paid off all their money that they had, they have done all kinds of pilgrimages, they have nurtured all kinds of nonsensical people. So they know everything. Like if you ask Mr. Warren, I mean, I don't know, they say this Ananda is my guru, that Bhogan, that Dhonganand is my guru, or that Bhoganand is my guru. He knows all of them. He said, Mother, I've been to all these things. I've seen this one and that one, everybody I've known. So they are also fed up. This fedding up really helps you to fade many misidentifications and fixations that you have. And these fixations are the things that are still sticking on to you despite the fact you are aspiring for your self-realization. Amidst this chaos, Mataji Nirmala Devi has to come and has to tell you that you better see your space, which is spotless, which cannot be soiled, which is eternal, which is within your heart. You don't have to go anywhere to seek it. It's within your heart. It's such a beautiful thing that is settled. Whatever age you may be born, whatever chaos you may be, whatever trouble you may be, it exists within your heart as your spirit. You know how to just become that is a simple thing. And in this chaos, only Sahaja Yoga had to become Mahayoga, is the great yoga today. Unless and until human beings had reached that stage of frustration, it would not have been possible. Can you imagine at the time of Christ, so many thousands of Sahaja Yogis I have now all over the world, to have them so much dedicated and understanding the powers of the Spirit. I mean, those 12 fishermen, it was impossible even to talk about Kundalini. I mean, it was an impossible task. And even till he was crucified, they could not, you see, they were halfway whether he is Christ. They had seen him walking on the water, they had seen all those miracles, but still they were still not believing him. That's typical of human beings, never to believe the reality. But if there's a falsehood, somebody puts up a big show, then everybody is down at the feet. And when Christ came on this earth, that time was such one of the worst times one can think of. And the way he rode the donkey to prove how stupid people would be who will try to follow Christ. These are the Christian nations who say they worship Christ. They have dominated the whole world today. In this country, how many Indians are killed? Think of that. What we have done, we are Christians, the one Christ who said that, forgive them for they do not know what they are doing. Forgiveness is the power of Christ and what we have done to the whole world. Think of it. But that consciousness is also coming today. I'm very happy to know that we are getting even that that understanding of dominating nature, of our ego, that how in our ignorance he came to kill your ego. He came against the ego. He came to show that human beings should control their ego, should get over it. It was he who was crucified because of the ego of the people. Why was he crucified? What did he say? What did he say? He just said that I am the Son of God. He is, and he will be, and he is there. Whether you like it or not, whether you crucify him, he is. Only for saying that, you crucified him. Now, I'm very tactful. I know the ego is so much. It's a donkey. It's a donkey. People say ego is like a monkey. I would say it's more a donkey than a monkey. I mean, the monkey evolves into the stupid donkey stage. That's what it is. And all kinds of stupidity we are doing in the name of ego. This is the right side movement. With all this advancement, the byproduct of that we got is the ego, which thinks, rationalizes everything. And the behavior of egoistical man is such that others can see that he cannot see. The extreme of ego, we can say the ideal of ego or the epitome of ego was Hitler. He never knew that he was egoistical, never. And anybody who comes in contact with the egoistical man also gets so much enveloped to the ego part of it that they all joined hands with it. And then they built a kind of a guilt within themselves, which is even more dangerous. You have seen the fundamentalists, how egoistical they are. Nobody can put any sense into their head. They believe in it, I believe. Who is this I which is believing into it? Is this Mr. Yellow colored bile in your head called as ego? And this ego is one of the biggest barriers between you and yourself. You're not your ego. You're not. It's a myth. It's a balloon. It's just a balloon in your head which has misled you. You are your spirit, which is beautiful, which is a collective being, which is not just to believe in, but see, you just become collectively conscious. You just actualize in your awareness the existence of the spirit. You feel it in the central nervous system, the existence of spirit. This ego, the more you see it, the more you just laugh at it. How idiotic it makes you, how stupid it makes you. And the ego expresses a man in such a way that he is not connected to the whole at all. He has no connectivity of any. He is on his own. What's wrong? What's wrong in everything? What's wrong in this? But only when the Kundalini rises, she says, oh God, now this fellow has been doing this nonsense. You can see it yourself. You get separated from yourself. You start seeing yourself as a cloth upon you, your body. You start seeing yourself like your car, which is away from you. You are not your car. Then you start seeing what's wrong with it. After realization only you see, oh God. I know of so many who come and tell me, Mother, my agya is catching. Means there's a lot of ego in me. And they see it so clearly. Collectively we are seeing it. Collectively we are seeing it, but not individually. But individuals only make for the collective, don't we? But once we start seeing it individually, collectively we can cure it. So this is the barrier. And those people who are ego-oriented get the ego enveloped on their heart, because the ego goes just like that. Moves this way, that it goes to the right side. It comes up to the left. It spreads from here to this side. And the super-ego from here to this side. But when you get more egoistical and more egoistical, it starts spreading like this. Now the problem with ego is that it doesn't harm yourself. You don't get any pain with it. You don't get any trouble. But others are harmed. So rather difficult to cure. With the superego, you are harmed. You feel the pain. You feel pain here, pain there. You feel funny. You feel lost. All those things happen. But the ego, if it is pure ego, it can go to any limit of destruction of others. And that's why all these fundamentalists, those people say, I believe, they are so aggressive and they are responsible for the destruction of colonies of colonies of people. They have no love, they have no compassion. This movement in the West is much more than anywhere else, I would say, because suddenly with this machine age, they thought that we are going to rule the whole world. And that's how they are responsible in a way that they do not see the danger of ego on other people. But I personally think there is an awareness because the way they have taken to alcoholism, it's a reaction to them. They can't bear the ego too much, so they take to alcoholism. Though with all this advancement, one good thing has come out, that they have started seeing. They have started seeing it that we are going too far with our ego. Now the effects of this, physically what happens, let us see. It's very important to see what is the effect of ego development within us. If your right side is overdeveloped, the first thing happens, I told you, that it encircles your heart and your heart starts becoming smaller and smaller. And such person can become like Hitler without any heart. Divorces will take place. No forgiveness, no compassion, no love. I have known people in India who are doing a lot of social work. If you see them in person, you can't stand near them. They are heat. They think, we are doing this great work of social work and this and that. I mean, what is the social work? It's part and parcel of your being. You see, if your one finger is out of order or there's something wrong, you try to treat it. I mean, I'm not treating anyone, I'm treating myself only. There's no obligation, I'm treating myself. Is something wrong with you? You are me. Who is the other? When you think there is the other, this is ego. That creates, he's the other and I'm the one who is helping. Whom to help? You are helping yourself. Just you are helping yourself. But this ego develops and such social workers and such great redeemers come out with such ego characters. I know of one lady who is supposed to be a great social worker in India, respected everywhere and all that. I happened to see her on a plane. And she brought out some sort of a funny thing with her. And she came on the plane and she wanted to sit in the front, this thing. And the gentleman, you see, was saying that, I'm sorry, I have to sit here, I'm sick, and my wife is sick, and we have specially reserved the seat, you cannot sit there. She said, do you know who I am? She said, whatever you may be, but I'm sick. You're not sick, so let me sit here. No, I have to sit. I have to sit here, and I have to do it. And she quarreled with everyone, and the way she was dancing from places to places, nobody could say that there is anything of love or decency in that. But she's supposed to be a great social worker. All her face is wrinkled all over. Nobody would like to look at her face. Such people, such hard-hearted matrons, they are doing God's work. You have to have that. You have to have understanding. You have to have patience. But they have no knowledge. Knowledge is the knowledge of divine love. How God loves you. How He forgives you. How He is compassionate. This is missing from the ego-oriented people. Now, this heart gets completely enveloped by it. So in the beginning, as I told you yesterday, when you are too much on the right-hand side, first thing you will develop is the freezing of the left side. Means emotionally, you become absurd. I mean, it's like a military. You see, if a man who is ego-oriented falls in love, it's like a military man moving like a machine, you see. You don't know how. It's a big joke. Falling in love of an ego-oriented man. I can't understand such a man, how he must be behaving. Now, such a man, first of all, becomes, as I told you, an emotionless personality. He has no emotions. He cannot enjoy his emotions. Secondly, physically, he gets all the troubles of the left side, means he might get his diabetes, he might get, with his franticness and speediness, he might get blood cancer, he might get his liver too because he's thinking too much, because of his thinking process his liver also goes out, so he has got liver, and if he wants to compensate his ego with alcoholism, then he gets even cirrhosis of the liver, anything can happen. This is the sun line, it's the line of the sun. And such a person can get skin troubles and skin diseases and lot of heat in the body. he can have tremendous heat all the time in the body. Such person can be heated and very, very agitated, and he cannot talk to anyone for 5 minutes without getting into franticness. Such a person cannot have a good married life. His children would be worried about him. He would become, after some time, a heart patient. That's the end of it. He becomes a heart patient and dies of heart. But even I've seen people, those who get their heart troubled and are about to die, still they are discussing money, still they are discussing business. They don't know tomorrow they are going to die, but they are discussing. They are very alert. They are very alert in brain. Just imagine the balancing part is that the heart goes out, not the brain, though they have used their brain bit too. This is the right side, which is called as the Surya Nadi, which is the Prana Shakti, which we use too much, and for using that, we have to suffer because we do not have the left side, the balancing part. Now, the left side, as I told you yesterday, is the emotional side of a man. The emotional side, the Chandra Nadi. The Chandra means the moon, but we use the word Luna. You know that Luna means that, and Lunatic means the man who is affected by the left side. The people who use too much of this become mad, schizophrenic. You see, their emotions are disturbed from childhood. I mean, it's an action reaction. A child is born in a family with a father who is right-sided, mother who is right-sided. They are fighting with each other all the time. The child feels his emotions are neglected. I mean, imagine, I was surprised first when I discovered in Switzerland that you don't allow your little children to sleep with you. I mean, I was amazed. I mean, we can't think of such a thing. Do you know this? In America, you have lived there, do you know that they don't allow the little children to sleep with the mother? I mean, this we cannot think of. I mean, any mother can't sleep in India if the little baby is sleeping in another room. I mean, for us, it is impossible to conceive an idea that a little baby is left in the other room. I discovered it because one girl, she told me that she lost her child when he was sleeping. I said, how it happened? She said, the child was sleeping in the other room. I said, only 1 month old child was sleeping in another room? How can that? But it's all due to some sort of a black magic, I think, that the whole thing happened. But then I discovered many people whose children died in their sleep and they didn't know. I mean, imagine little children left in the other room. And why? For what? It's so absurd. This is what it is. I mean, there's no love for your child. An Indian woman can't live without her children. I mean, when I was coming to America, so many told me that if you are going, give this to my son, give this to my child, give this. I said, now am I going to really hold it with all that? The customs will eat me off. Oh no, he's very fond of this kind of laddus, this kind of food. Please tell them, all the love of the mothers was coming up. You see, my son, he doesn't eat much, but if you take him, you can't get this kind of a vegetable. I said, now you take the whole vegetable there. So much concern. But when I came here, last time there was a boy who had a heart attack in Los Angeles. I said, where's your mother? He said, he was quite an elderly boy, I would say about 25 years of age. And I said, where's your mother? She's in New York. And what about, she's not come here? You've got a heart attack? So, you know, she is remarried and she's enjoying her romance. I mean, I don't understand these women. At the age of 50 years, what romance are they enjoying with another man there? It's absurd. These people are really absurd. I can't understand these women. They have no motherhood in them. How can you be like that? I mean, I just can't think. To me, every Sahaja Yogi is so dear. It's all right. Forget about me. But even an average mother. Here what I find, mothers have no feelings for this. I mean, this generation especially is suffering so much. When I see them, so many Sahaja Yogis, oh, my mother doesn't care for me. Only she says that you don't care for me, this, that. But I have a feeling that even a son may not be good to the mother. But the mother cannot give up her love. How can she give up? How can it be possible? I just cannot think of a mother. Those Indians who are sitting there, let them tell me this. They have got their mothers. They cannot give up their love for their children. But it has happened because of this Mr. Ego coming in. It has created this problem here in these people that the mothers have become so cruel to their children. All these things can happen to you. A father can become absolutely cruel. Absolutely cruel. I mean, I have seen to so many sahajogis, a father becoming cruel on a simple point, and he would not look at his children. They are starving. I mean, in India people accumulate money to give it to their children. But here it's nothing like that. Even old Johnnies of 80 years are having a romance, and the poor son is begging on the street. He's not bothered. How can it be? I mean, I just can't understand. The whole fatherhood is missing. Whole love is missing. That sense of security that the children should have is missing. It's absolutely missing. One of the things that has happened by this, the greatest thing, that your children have lost that sense of security and that love, that wisdom that you had to give them. You didn't have wisdom, I should say, so the children didn't get it. And now these thugs have come from India to grab them at this point. Your young people are lost because of the mistakes. I would say even the war may be responsible. The war has not have done this. War might have finished your idealism, your values, your love and affection, maybe. But it has affected so badly, that even the ordinary love, so many sahajogis come to me and tell me that my mother never loved me, my father never loved me. I'm amazed. How can it be that a father and mother cannot love? And this has happened because of this ego development in these countries. But we Indians have much worse defects in us also, which I will tell you tomorrow, what sort of nonsense we can do also. I mean, how we do sins against the father while you don't sin against the mother. Because of ego orientation, morality was finished. Morality has no value. I mean, it's such a danger. You don't know with whom you stand. I mean, you allow somebody to come in your house. Say, supposing you have an Indian in your house as a guest, he may run away with all your things. See, he may run away. It's possible. They are thieves of things, possessions, they will take your money, all that. But they will not run away with your wife or with your daughter. But if you allow another Westerner to come in, you don't know how far he stands with your wife or with your daughter or anything. He may run away with you. When I know which one to choose, I don't know. This is what it is. And Indians have their attention on the material things, what to get out of this person. As long as you give them money, they are very happy. Give them money, feed them, and they want only nothing but the money, 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 money. That's all. But you people want one woman in this house, you go to another house, you want another woman. Now we had one problem in London, a sahajogi carrying on with 5 sahajoginis. I mean, what sort of a sahajogi you are? What sort of these poor sahajoginis are? I just can't imagine. And you see, it is something so funny for the people who are seeking God to be like that. Like I told you, it's one gentleman wanted to have 59 Rolls Royce, one thug, you see. He calls himself God or whatever he may call himself. He's a thug. He wanted to have 59 Rolls Royce. So people starved themselves and gave him that 59 Rolls Royce. And this thug is going to go to hell, no doubt. There's no doubt about it. And he's going to be punished for those 59 Rolls Royce. But the 59 Rolls Royce, when they gave, when the people went and approached them, that why did you give him a Rolls Royce? What is the need to give him? They said, we gave him just the metal, he is giving us the spirit. They think that you can exchange the metal for spirit. Just look at this stupidity, then that's why I said, isn't it stupidity? How can you pay for your realization? That simple. It is love of God. But one thing should be there, that you are very intelligent and you are sharply intelligent. And try to understand one point, that you can't pay for your love. Love is something you cannot purchase in the market. And if God is love, you cannot purchase love. So this is what I want to tell you about the right side. Tomorrow I'll tell you about the left side as well. But tomorrow I would like to tell you about the different centers that are within us. The first center within us is the center called as Muladhara. It's the center of Muladhara. Now this is a very important center, one has to understand. It's the root, it's the support of the root. It's the support of the root. Means the root is the Kundalini, and this center is the support of the Kundalini. It is supporting. It is the center of innocence. And this center is the one that records everything that conditions us. You see, the whole conditioning from the left side passes into the first set. And Kundalini records it just like a tape recorder. She records everything. I have seen people with Kundalini, they have got holes, bleeding. Some of them have Kundalini which just tosses the head with helplessness and wants to come up. She cannot. We have harmed her so much by our wrong idea. This Kundalini rests there and is recording all the information she gets from the conditioning of the person. A thought rises in the mind and falls off, another rises in the mind and falls off. Now, whatever falls off goes to the past. The whole is sucked in by that, the information about you is sucked in by this center and is conveyed to the Kundalini who keeps in you. When she rises, she tells you. On your fingers, you can feel it. Where is the problem? On the left hand side. On the left hand side, you can feel the person's chakras, which is catching through the Kundalini awakening, which she unwinds herself. When she rises, she tells you what mistake they have committed. Now, this center on the left hand side, if it catches, is a very dangerous sign and is one of the worst times. When a person uses sex for God, or a perverted sex, or all sorts of, what do you call that? All kinds of sex activities you people do. I mean, there's no end to it. I mean, I don't want to describe it, but I mean, horse, dogs, and everything put together, all that nonsense. See? And all kinds of fixations about sex that show on this part. If it burns there, you get this problem. And there, if you can somehow awaken your innocence, through Sahaja Yoga you can get back your innocence. You can. The one that is lost is not lost. You can awaken it. Then this center here can be awakened and nourished. The result of this is, when this center is spoiled, you get all these dirty diseases that you get from perverted sex. Impotency is one of them. Those people who talk that do sex, see, there was a lady who came to see me and she said, I got rid of sex by going to a person who said that sex is the way to God. There's another man who came to me. They both were impotent, absolutely impotent. Impotency in this country is so high, I mean, if you see, I mean, the magnitude of that is so high. That's why for you sex act itself has become something great. I mean, itself you think that sex, to do sex act is something great, which is so natural. Because of these people coming down and putting these ideas, you know, Mr. Freud is one of them. Mr. Freud is the beginning of the half-baked, horrible people who accepted him as the leader. I mean, he must have influenced some people in India, but nobody bothered. You see, we are like an elephant walk without taking any notice of such people. But it has influenced, and that has ruined the chances of realization in many people because their left Muladhara chakra is gone out. We don't tell you when you give realization. We give energy there, energy of love, of forgiveness, and try to nourish it. But as soon as you get realized, your ideas about sex also become very much better. Now, the greatest problem you have in Los Angeles, as they told me, that 65% people in Los Angeles are homosexual. I mean, it's something I can't believe. I didn't know what sort of a thing is this. Actually, for an Indian lady to talk this is so shameful. I mean, I don't know how to talk about it. But I have seen that this happens not only by spoiling this center, but by getting a possession onto it. A man gets a possession of a woman. He gets possessed by an entity who is a woman. Then he starts behaving like a woman. In New York, we had one boy who came to us and he was talking like a lady. I couldn't understand why he was. Then they said, even these people are good at finding out. They say, I'm not so good. So they told me, Mother, he is like that. His possession was removed and he was perfectly a man. It's only when a woman is possessed by a man or a man possessed by a woman, these things happen. I have cured now thousands of Western people with this disease. Now they have become absolutely normal people, because when you start doing too much of that nonsense there, perversions, experiments with sex, either you become absolutely impotent, or if you move too much to the left-hand side, you go into collective subconscious, you get possessed, and you get things like this. I mean, it's something absurd. It was never so in the history of human beings, such a big problem. Now today it is a problem because you do not know from where it comes. It comes because you get possessed. If the possession is removed, you become absolutely normal. So this is one of the dangers of getting into the problem of the left Muladhara chakra, by which, as I told you, you get all kinds of diseases, which are sanctum sanctorum. See, one of our servants who came from India, we are allowed to have three servants, and I had a very old servant of mine who was 75 years of age. He was a good cook, and I didn't want to leave him in India, so brought him a good man. Good, as we call him, dharmi, nice man. He came to England. Can you imagine, at that age, there was an old lady who met him, about 72 years of age. And she called him to his house, and he contacted her very badly. Imagine at that age, how could he, I don't know what they must have done. He went to the doctor, and doctor sent him to a hospital. It's all a secret. They never told us what is this hospital for, and used to go there, take injections, and what sort of a disease this fellow has got. There was an Indian doctor in that hospital who was a friend of another Indian doctor we knew. So we asked this doctor, what is he going there for? Every Thursday he goes there, and what is he doing there? We don't know what is the disease this fellow has got. Oh God, then he found out, he told us that this hospital is for, this is a sanctum sanctorum, you are not supposed to know about it. And then this doctor told us that this is such a disease and it's contagious. Immediately we sent him to India. And he had all these pornographic pictures given by this lady to him. She was writing love letters. I mean, I just think of it. I mean, Indians can't even understand this nonsense, you see, because we are not so developed. And 75-year-old man, can you imagine? This had happened to him. I used to catch on his left Muladhara and said, at this age, what is he chatting about? That's all I knew. But I could not imagine that he has gone so far. And this is what exactly is happening, that we do not know that we have to respect our chastity. Men or women, our whole power is in our chastity. We should have self-esteem, and we should respect ourselves. It happened. After realization, I've seen all the Sahaja Yogis have become different. They have become so innocent, so simple, so loving, and so pure. It happens because Kundalini is the one that cleanses you, she clears you, and she puts you in that state where you are absolutely washed, cleaned, and laid. The other problems from these centers are even much more serious, which I don't know how far I can go with it, because it's all medical terms and all that, and I don't want to confuse it. But I would say that the best thing is for people who get realization to see for themselves that in transmutation they work it out diligently to cleanse their ideas about morality. You have to lead a life of a very sane married person. Very sane married people. We have to have very good married life. You'll be amazed, our Sahaja Yogis are married. Yesterday Gregor, who spoke to you, has married a girl from Switzerland. They're very happy. They have a very sweet child who is a born Devahi. Here the deity is Sri Ganesha. He's the deity who looks after the birth of a child, who retains the fetus, who nourishes the fetus, and at the right moment expels it. And this is only possible when the child knows that he's been born to parents who are realized souls, and that they are going to love him and care for him. Such love flows among Sahaja Yogis, such understanding, such beautiful things. There's no insecurity, because they become so pure. It's such a beautiful thing to see. It's not a forced thing, it is not brainwashed, but they just become that. And the understanding is so great that even people where the marriage system is built up from the childhood, I have not seen such understanding as I have seen in people who get their realization. This is the blessing of Sri Ganesha at this stage, and he is the beginning. He is the Omega. He is the one who incarnates on this earth as Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Alpha and he is the Omega. He is the Om. He is that word about which you have heard. It is that Omkara, that Pranava. He is the one who comes on this earth to tell us that thou shalt not have adulterous. And how you get adulterous, I think I'll tell you tomorrow about it. May God bless you. It has been a little heavy lecture today, and sometimes we have to go into little heaviness to get rid of some of our heaviness. And tomorrow, I hope we'll enjoy the left side much better. May God bless you. If you have any questions, please ask. Thank you. Just to clear out your right side, we have to go into details of it. Thank you very much. May God bless you. Now some questions if you have. Yes, please.
I was wondering about the nectar technique. That's advisable, or should I leave it alone?
Which technique?
Nectar.
What technique?
He was asking whether the nectar technique is advisable.
What is nectar technique?
Ketchari.
Ketchari.
Not at all. That's what I told. Kabira has written about the ketchari business, you see. Any technique is not admissible before realization. After realization, you have to learn the divine technique. For example, now supposing this is the instrument, all right? Or you see if there is an instrument which is not any instrument, which is not yet connected to the main. By turning this, by talking on it, pushing this, dismantling this, or adding to it, will it work? On the contrary, I'll spoil it. Like the car, which is not yet started. Just by moving the wheels, by moving the small little parts of it, will it work? No technique is there before realization. Realization is a mystery, you can say. It's a mystery, like any sprouting of the seed is a mystery. You can't say how it works. It works, isn't it? In the same way, the sprouting of your Kundalini, the awakening of Kundalini, works. Then you get connected. Now how it works? Can you say the electricity is inside the plug, all right, and this gets connected and it works? How? You can't explain. Why there is gravity in the Mother Earth? Can you say that? You can't. But once it is connected, then you should know the plugs and things, and you should know which divine, all right? So no technique is needed before that. This nectar business, I don't know from where this idea has come. The fourth area which Krishna has described in Gita is of Kriya Yoga. That he says that the bandha takes place. When the Kundalini rises, it goes into a bandha. Of course it does, because if the Kundalini has to rise, then it is to be supported. But you don't do it. It is done by the system itself, it works out. But if it has not yet awakened, what are bandhas you are doing? What nonsense you are doing, you see? Like you are going through a road, all right? Then you have to pay the tolls. In America, you have to pay tolls at every, say, bridge, according to the bridge. But if you are sitting down here, do you pay the tolls? You understand my point? When the Kundalini moves, then you should know what center you have to cross, what you have to do, that's the difference. But first the Kundalini must move. Do you follow the point?
I need further clarification.
Beg pardon?
No, please clarify further.
I'll tell you how. Supposing we have to go from here to another place, all right? On the way you have to pay the toll.
Yeah, I understand that.
All right, sitting down here you don't pay the toll.
Right.
when you are moving at a particular gate, you know what is to be paid, you pay there and go ahead, then pay there and go ahead, like that you move. The Kundalini must move. You must know what center is catching. You must know where you have to go. You see, all these things are so artificial that nothing has been done and you are just playing with it and spoiling it. It's artificial. You understand, Mahapanda?
Well, there's a point this that rather than go and try to figure out, that you let go and let it happen.
That's it. Yeah. Let it go, let it happen. And then you figure it out with the knowledge that you have on your finger. You know which one is catching. Now supposing your this center is catching, means the nabi on the left hand side. You must know why it's catching. You must know what deities are there, how to awaken it, and you must know how to cure it. Then the Kundalini moves. And you see the movement. Of course, at the first shot, a part of the Kundalini pierces, no doubt. And you start feeling the cool breeze and all that. But then you start understanding where is the problem, on what center it is. And then you can start relieving those centers by understanding the technique, which is a divine technique.
What is it that you experience on your hands?
You feel, you see, first of all you feel the cool breeze, which is all-pervading power, as cool breeze of the Holy Ghost around, all right? Then you start feeling, now you want to think about it, say, what's wrong with me? You just put your hands like this. And then you start feeling, not at the first shot, you may not. First shot you might feel only the breeze blowing, you see, it's a, but gradually you develop that sensitivity. Then you know it's happening here. Some people who do not have sensitivity on the finger, they can feel it within themselves. That it's going there, it's here, there. You also can feel on other people. When you move the Kundalini, you can see it stopped here. Like yesterday, Dr. Varadika, he's got his realization only 2 days back. And he was moving, he said, no, it has stopped here, Mother, it's not going further. You can feel it. Then if it has stopped at a point, you see, say, at the Christ point, then you have to say Lord's Prayer. If it has stopped at Vishuddhi Chakra, then you have to say Allahu Akbar. You have to say Krishna's Mantra. All these things you must understand. And then it works out. And you will be amazed how it works out.
So, the way you're using the word realized soul, that someone who is aware of how the energy is moving through the chakras and what point it's being blocked, and a particular way of unblocking that particular chakra, and then when they feel that the energy is moving through the chakras, then that's how you're using that word, realized soul.
Are you defining a realized soul as a person who knows where the Kundalini is,
what chakra is blocked? Of course. I mean, that's the minimum. That's the minimum you feel. You feel all the chakras, your own, you feel the chakras of another person. You know how to cure them, you know how to give realization, that's the minimum of minimum. Yes, that's the minimum. Those who say, that's what yesterday I said, those who say we are self-realized, some say we are born again, ask them, what are the centers catching in me? Where is the Kundalini? Ask them, that's it, you will know all that, that's the minimum. I mean, that's nothing. That's the minimum you should know. You see, you are a great instrument, like a big television, as I told you. You, as soon as you put it to the maze, the whole thing manifests. You are made like that. It is hard to believe, but you are. You are that. You are fantastically made. After all, thousands of years have been spent on you to make a human being. It is, but you see, we don't believe it. It's too much. But it happens, really. Just believe it, it happens. So now, what's another question? Some people got it yesterday? Just like that? Yes?
I was wondering about eating meat as opposed to vegetarian.
He's wondering about eating meat as opposed to eating vegetables.
You see, this is also another idea of these Brahmins. It's another nonsense, you see, vegetarianism and all this. This is all nonsense. Am I going to give realization to chickens? It's nothing important. But you shouldn't eat animals which are bigger than you in size. Then you become funny, you see. But animals which are smaller than you, it's all right. What is this vegetarianism? Nonsense. Kabira used to eat, Nanaka used to eat, Rama used to eat, Krishna used to eat, all of them used to eat. And what about the goddess? she had to not only eat but drink the blood of these nonsensical devils which are back on this earth. How can she be vegetarian? This is all nonsensical ideas. Those people, I've seen most of these thugs do that. Because if you become vegetarian, you become weak and then hate them. This is the trick. I mean, I don't say that you should go on eating it, but what I'm saying is nothing important. Not much importance should be given to food. Nowadays there's another thing, health food. I mean, some of these things that they sell in the health food is only meant for buffalo, not human beings. That's horrible. I mean, they have these wheat, not even grinded. Once I ate that bread and I had such a pain in the stomach, I said, who eats this? Why are you becoming martyrs for nothing at all? There is no need to be such martyrs, starving yourself. You are God's own people. You are going to get realization. Oh, you are so beautiful. Why should you bother yourself so much about this? There's no need. You have done everything except for hanging yourself by the nearest tree. Why? What is that mean? It's not important. I mean, if you don't want to eat it, don't eat. But if you are eating, you can eat it. We are not going to give realization to bugs and mosquitoes. In India, we have vegetarianism of this extreme that people, there's one cult or sect which gets a Brahmin into a hut. And lots of bugs of the whole village are collected, and that poor Brahmin has to feed these bugs and he's paid money for that. Now the bugs are more important than a human being. Can you imagine how many bugs are to be sacrificed to make a human being normally? Oh, we have sects like that, vegetarianism.
Any more questions?
Moreover, those who are real vegetarians, they catch on the left navi, we have seen, they have a problem. It's all right, if you are not eating, it's all right. If you are not eating, it's all right. But if somebody forces you not to eat, tell them this is not good. Nothing important. You are the spirit. You are the spirit, you see. It has nothing to do. I mean, you don't go and kill the animals.
Yes.
It is a logical thing one should understand. That say in a country like Greenland, there is not even a leaf grows. Do you mean to say God is going to make them suffer because there is no leaf of any vegetable growing there? How can they live without it? In countries, even in the Middle East, it's difficult to get vegetables in certain places. In Holland I saw during winter time, it's an impossible. Not now, but about 10 years back. So you mean to say these people are all going to be cut out of the plan of God? Vegetarianism is all right for India when it's a very hot country. I mean, not Islam, but I mean, we eat more vegetables. But meat is all right. Also those who can afford it and can afford it even physically, because it's a hot country. In a hot country, people normally take to more vegetables, and in those countries, vegetables also grow more. See, it's all God looks after you. There is no mental, rational way of sorting out these things.
Can you define spirit?
That I'm going to do tomorrow, a complete lecture. If you come tomorrow, I will tell you all about it. All right?
Yeah.
Definitely. But spirit doesn't mean these dead spirits. Somebody gets possessed and says, I am become spirit, you see, these Pentecostals. And they start jumping like mad people and they say they are, it's not possession. It is spirit is within you, atma. There's no word in English language. You look at the alcohol is spirit, a dead spirit is a spirit, and your atma is a spirit. It's what a confusion.
Wild horses.
But tomorrow I'll tell you. Satchit Ananda. I'll tell you tomorrow. Satchit Ananda. Truth, attention, enlightened attention, and the joy. Tomorrow I'll tell you.
Okay, shall we have it now?
Yes.
Everybody just, if you haven't slipped your shoes off, do so.
Yes, please. You see, that and helps. Also, I will tell you why I say, because the Mother Earth helps us. See, just sit.
Be humble, ask for it. If you've got doubts in your mind, be open-minded enough to say, okay.
He's saying all this because he has suffered because of that, you see. So he's trying to help you. I will tell you sometimes about the stories of the people who came to me. It's interesting, you know, to see them like little children. Just put both the feet just straight like that, and both the hands like that, just like this. And please close your eyes. You can remove your glasses, will help you. Glasses you can remove. If there is anything tight on your body, you can just loosen it. And if you have anything of your guru or something you are wearing in your neck, please remove it. That doesn't help. Now put your hands straight like that. Most of them have got it.
Yes, it's very cool.
You will feel the cool breeze in your hand. Most of you have got it. All right? I got it. Just put straight. Don't think about it. Just it will work out. It's a living thing that works within you.
Done.
Put your hand straight. You feel it around. There. All around. What is?
Feels more warm.
Huh?
Feels more warm than cool.
All right. Then it's something. It's all right. It will work out. Let it work out. Keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes open. Aapke ho gaya sadaji? Hua ki nahi hua? Tandak. Paar hona sahi hai. Inko samjhaiye ye jo hain. Ye kya kar rahe hain pata nahi yahan par. भगवान का धंधा नहीं करना चाहिए. आप समझा दीजिए उनको. गलत चीज कभी नहीं करना चाहिए. बड़ा पाप लगता है. चक्करों में घूमना ही नहीं इसके. बेटा इट विल कूल डाउन. Put your left hand on this side. Yes, that will be. If he thinks hot. Is it hot? On this side, on the liver. On this side. No, it's correct. You are all right. You on the right hand side. Right hand side. Yes, please. Now put the right hand like this, straight. Are you all right? You are all right. You got it yesterday. Now today I will teach you how to raise the Kundalini of others. Right? Those who got realization yesterday are going to help me today. Got it. Now don't doubt and don't think, otherwise it will disappear. For a while you have to be careful. Have you got it? Put your right hand towards me like this. Yeah. On the other side.
Yes, please, Sasha.
Are you feeling the cool breeze? Are you feeling the cool breeze on your head? Just say here. May not be the hand. Are you feeling hair?
Cool.
Are you feeling on your hand? On your hand? You can feel it on your head also. Are you feeling? The sadhus can see for themselves. Are you feeling? Good. Are you? We'll come and see. You have got a throat problem, is it? Yes, you have. We'll work it out. We'll work it out.
Not feeling it.
She's a Sahaja Yogini.
Balance it up.
What is it?
Huh? No, that's just the relinquish. I want you to feel it.
You can join Pradhan, he will tell you. Pradhan, Dana Sangha. If you join him, he'll tell you how to raise the Kundalini. Please go and join him. You can wear your shoes.
Mm-hmm.
with Sister Pradhan. He's one of the oldest Sahajogi we have. For 11 years he has been with me. He came to me. Now, are you all right?
The energy is coming.
Not yet? Tumi baga na?
Switch off.
I'm trying to pay attention.
Just see.
She's got a very bad liver problem, Mother, and skin problem.
Is it? All right, doesn't matter. It will work out. Thank you.
She's not feeling it, unfortunately.
Very kind of,
She's not feeling it, that's the problem.
No, it's all right. Just on her head, just keep it for a while, all right? Till liver is all right.
You think it's liver? Is she liver?
What about this lady? She had it yesterday again. What? Are you all right? Are you getting the cool breeze now? No, you. You are feeling what?
I feel good.
That's not enough. That's not enough. See, you should be a perfectionist about it, isn't it? Ah. No, she has.
Just,
very hot.
Just leave it there. Like, okay? Just let it work out.
Yeah, what does it?
Great, you will. Put your right hand above your head in there.
See this gentleman, somebody?
Are you feeling?
She's all right? She's got it. He's got it. How are you now? How is your trouble?
Green psoriasis? Still there. Bubby head? The skin?
Just the same?
No, don't worry here. I think it's a little better. I'm not sure.
All right. Now put your left hand on your liver. You know where the liver is?
The liver is not... This is psoriasis, not cirrhosis.
No. Psoriasis also is caused by bad liver.
Oh, is it?
All right? Now put your both the feet on the ground. And one hand towards me. All right. Right hand. Yeah. Hari, what do you think? Doctor said, "Tumi baga ta ek do, par hota tha kare." Kya? Isse kaise dala hai? Kya muli sa? Then kya muli sa baga ha? Alaka, tell her how to do it. Come along, you come and help now others. Come along, she can help others. Come along. Ingrid, you get up now. Please see this gentleman. Now, you just keep your hands tight, all right? It will work out. You have a liver problem, so it has to go a little. The kundalini will be striking there. It's all right. It will work out. Is it? What is she catching? This lady? Left sarita.
Right.
Left to the right, you put it down. Just work it out. What about this gentleman? Kai? Hansa Kai? Huh? Kai Munta? That side la, right la. And left la? Why? Right to left la gala. Right to Ustun left la gala. No, right to Ustun and left la gala. No, right to the left. This one is left to the right. What about this gentleman, Hari? Kasa kaya tensa? Tumi swatha cha missus la bagay cha nahi, doctor? Dusra na bagay cha. Somebody else has to see her. त्यांना बघतील कोणते हा व्हॉट इज इट शुद्धी बोस ऑलराईट इज ऑलराईट आर यू फीलिंग द कूल बी इन द हँड नॉट इन हँड जस्ट पुट युअर हँड बॅक लेट हिम आस्क मी Just say, Mother, please give me my realization. Mother, please give me my realization. Okay. All right? Is it all right? Right hand? You go.
There is a little booklet available for 50 cents and get a photograph and you can work it out. But as I said, let mother work on you if possible.
Thank you.